Good evening, everyone. I'm Sheila Bain and I'm Vice Chairman of the branch. And it's my pleasure tonight to welcome you all to our Christmas dance. Who would have thought back in March at the spring dance that it would be the last time in 2020 that we would dance together? But tonight we've got the lively music from Ian Thompson, but sadly without his band, to play for us. We've had to learn a lot of new things since COVID came in, and one of them for me was Zoom. It totally has a different meaning now. My first attempt at Zoom was to go to the Dance Scottish at Home Wednesday evening classes, and they were organised by our very own branch member Angela Young. She's done so well and worked so hard for the branch that at the autumn gathering she was awarded the Scroll of Honour, and she totally deserved it. And I'm sure we would all like to congratulate her on being awarded it and tell her to keep up the good work, because I, for one, really enjoy the Wednesday evenings. So this is our second attempt at a Zoom evening, and our first one went down very well and we were delighted by all the emails we received congratulating us and encouraging us to do more. So here we are tonight with the Christmas dance, and the programme is made up by yourselves, because way back in the planning of the 95th ball, there was an email went out to all the members and they sent in their requests. So this 11 dances that's on tonight didn't make the cut for the ball, but has made it onto tonight's programme. So the committee also thought they would try something new tonight, and instead of teachers recapping the dances, we asked all the committee to take one each, and if they didn't want to recap it, they could maybe ask a friend or their teacher. And we almost succeeded, but there's still a few shy people on the committee. Anyway, tonight's dances are all just a wee bit different, and they've got lots of nice formations. So whether you put on your pumps or you sit back and relax with maybe a cup of tea or a tipple of your choice, enjoy what's on offer. And there will be a break at half time, so don't go away, because there might be a surprise for one branch member. So all that's left for me to say is, enjoy Ian's music, I hope it keeps your feet tapping all night, and over to you, Gail.
Hello, my name is Gail Fraser and I'm one of the committee members. I'm here to give you a brief history of the dance, The Aviator. This dance was devised by Carola Fisher for a man called Hans Prade on the occasion of his 80th birthday. Now, Hans was a keen glider, and Carola's father nicknamed him the Aviator. Hans once had a wonderful experience while out flying when he was joined by a buzzard who took advantage of the thermals, flew alongside the glider's wingtips and mirrored its movements. And the dance depicts Hans taking off, banking round, enjoying the flight with the buzzard, and then landing safely. The Dance the Aviator is from Book 52. It's a three-couple jig in a four-couple longwise set, and Carol has instructed the music to be any good light flowing jig, but not too fast. It begins with the ones leading down the middle. On bar four, the man crosses his partner in front. They cast up behind the fourth and third man into second place to face third lady. The two step up on bars three and four. The ones with the lady leading dance half alternating tandem reels with the first corner. The first man continues the reel, passing third lady left shoulder, while the first lady and third man turn left hand for the ones to face second lady. The ones, this time with the man leading, dance half alternating reel, tandem reels with the second corners. And the first lady continues the reel, passing the second lady left shoulder, while the first man and third lady turn left hands for the ones to end in second place on opposite sides with the First Lady facing out. The ones dance up, round by the twos by the right shoulder. That's the First Lady behind the second man and the first man in front of the second lady. They cast one place, dance across in second place on their own sides, and on the last two bars, all three couples set. This is a lovely wee dance. I enjoy dancing it with its interesting reels, and I hope you do too.
Thank you. I'm Sally Lawton, and this is my second year on the committee. I'm going to talk about the Countess of Dunmore's reel. The Countess of Dunmore was born in 1814, and at age 22, she married Alexander, who inherited the title Earl of Dunmore. However, Catherine was widowed some 11 years later, and she inherited over 150,000 acres in Harris, where she established a tweed-making business. This was the inspiration for Deirdre McCouche Bark from Toronto, who devised this reel in 2016, and it is included in book 49. Please enjoy this short demonstration and the dance.
Of Dunmore's reel out of book 49. First couple, set to each other, near hands joined, dance down, round the threes and cast up into second place, the twos having stepped up. You then set to each other, passing by the left to finish facing your first corner. Turn the first corner with the right hand, pass each other by the right, turn your second corner by the right hand, pass each other by the right to finish in second place facing out. The corners taking four bars to do the turn. There's then the chain progression. Ones, you're in second place, facing out, so you carry on and cast to your right. Whilst the twos and threes turn with the right hand three quarters of the way, you're now finish in a nice straight line. The two end couples, that's the first man and second lady, the first lady and third man in promenade hold, you will continue on halfway round the set. Whilst the second man and third lady who are in the centre, they turn with the left hand 1.5 times. Now the threes and the twos, you're now with your partner, turn with the right hand 3/4 of the way, whilst the ones continue on to finish second place on their own side of the dance. Threes, ones and twos dance clockwise halfway round the set, then the twos, ones and threes set to each other and cross, giving right hands, ready to start the dance again. ¶¶
Helen Crawford, and I've recently joined the committee of the RSCDS branch in Aberdeen. This next dance is called Farewell to Balfour Road, written in 2015 by Andrew Buxton for the Brighton and Hove Scottish Country Dance Club when they were moving from Balfour School in Balfour Road to Melscombe Hall. It's a 32 bar jig, five couple set. And interestingly enough, it's one of 21 dances in the RSCDS dictionary that start with farewell. However, it is the only one that says farewell to a road. I'll hand you over now to Jean Martin, who's going to call the dance.
Thank you, Helen. Farewell to Balfour Road is a five couple canon. And that means that every couple dances through once as first couple. Now, it begins with the first and second couples dancing four hands round and back. And then the first and second couples dance set and link. The first and third couples dance set and link, which brings the first couple into third place. At that point, first couple dance a reel of three with the fourth and fifth couples. The first couple going in and down, the second couple out and up, and the third couple in and up. At the end of the reel, the first couple set and cross, giving right hands, to fourth place. And then they set again and cross, this time giving left hands to fifth place. And now the canon. When the first couple are dancing reels of three with the fourth and fifth couples, the original second couple and third couple dance four hands round and back. They then set and link, and they then set and link with the what was the original fourth couple. And then they go into the reels of three, just as the first couple did. And the original first couple need to remember that when they get to the foot of the set, they are immediately into the reel of three, coming in and up. Enjoy it. Over to you, Ian. Thank you.
My name is Lindwood, Secretary of the Branch. Our next dance is Flower o' the Quern by John Drury. Quern stones are a pair of stone tools for hand grinding a wide variety of materials. It is believed that querns were introduced to Scotland around the time of the Roman invasion. The Flower of the Quern, also known as the Flower of the Quern, is also a traditional Scottish slow air by Scott Skinner, arranged by Alan Ferguson. Skinner wrote this air in the 1880s for a beautiful young widow from Forres.
Hi everyone, what a wonderful evening that we're having, and I'm sure that you're all really enjoying the music and enjoying yourselves. It's been excellent. So I'd like to invite you to take your partners for the next dance, Flower of the Quern. Flower of the Quern is a John Drury dance, a four couple strathspey in a long wide set, and there are two chords. On the second chord, third and fourth couples change places with their partners to begin the dance on the opposite side. The Flower of the Quern begins with first and second couples, and at the same time third and fourth couples. Circle once round to the left to finish in the centre of the set next to your partner, with first and third couples facing down and second and fourth couples facing up. You all set there, and then first couple turn towards each other and cast off into second place, while second couple dance up to the top, and third and fourth couple, you mirror that. So the fours turn towards each other and cast up into third place, while third couple dance down into fourth place. And on the last step, first man and fourth lady, and first lady and fourth man, as you're approaching each other on the sidelines, change places with left hands. So fourth couple, you're now in second place. You're going to lead up between the twos, cross over and cast off into second place on the opposite side, while the ones you repeat, while you the ones do the same going down. Lead down below the threes, cross over and cast up into third place. And on the last step of that, change places, left hands on the side again. You're going to repeat that, but going in the other direction. So the ones, you're going to be leading up around the twos, crossing over and casting into second place, while the fours, you're going to be leading down, crossing below the threes and dancing up into third place. And on the last step, again, change places on the side, left hands. So you're now in the order four, two, four, one, and three. The twos and ones facing down, the fours and threes facing up. The next eight bars are reels of four on the sidelines. Eight bar, right shoulder reels, and you finish where you started them. The last eight bars of the dance, everyone's set, facing the person that you've just passed in the reels. And then second lady with fourth man and first man with third lady, you're going to turn once round with the right hand. And at the same time, their partners, so second man with fourth lady and first lady with third man, you're turning once round with the left hand. The dance finishes with half figures of eight. The fours, you're going to dance up round the twos to finish in second place on your own side, while the ones, you're going to dance a half figure of eight down round the threes to finish in third place on the opposite side. So you finish in the order two, four, one, and three, with first and third couples on the opposite sides. It's a very wordy dance, and I can guarantee it's much easier to dance than it is to say, but it's a lovely dance. So enjoy the Flower of the Quern.
Thank you. Christina Mosley, and I'm a recently elected member of the Aberdeen RSCDS committee. In happier times, I dance with the Bankery group, and I'm going to introduce Rammer Dance, which has frequently been on our programme and is one of my favourites. It's a John Drury dance. He was a prolific dance compiler and wrote more than 800 dances, many of which have been published by the RSCDS. He worked for the University of Aberdeen, firstly as a biochemist and later in the computer department. He was a great traveller and often wrote dances relating to the places that he visited. This dance is from his Turkish set. The title is a wordplay around the two words Ramadan and dance. Ramadance is a 32-bar reel for three couples in a four-couple longwise set. And it starts, one's crossed down into Inveran reels with twos and threes, one's crossed by the right and cast one place, one's turned by the right, finishing facing first corners. Then the next eight bars are a meanwhile. Ones start by dancing around their first corner while the corners advance, half turn right hand, twirl and dance out to exchange places. Ones pass right shoulder and repeat with second corners, ones ending in second place, opposite sides. Then first man with the threes at the top and first lady with the twos dance half reels of three across the dance and then half reels of three on own sides, finishing in the order 2-1-3. Enjoy. Yeah.